Hello and welcome to my kitchen. I am Judith. I am getting ready for a picnic tomorrow. So I have a couple of things to prepare to fill up this lovely basket. I am going to make some shrimp sandwiches and we're going to use some herbs. Now it's your choice. You can use basil or dill, parsley, or a combination, and some green onion. And then we're going to do some ham and cheese. Well, cheese is going to be cream cheese, which we're also going to put in the shrimp sandwich. But we'll see how we're going to flavor that in a minute. And I have some lovely bread. Get my baker. Now, my baker makes mini loaves. So I have two mini loaves, one whole wheat and one white. And I get them to slice them horizontally. So then when I cut the crust off, I can roll them up into pinwheel sandwiches. So let me get started on making the shrimp salad. For our shrimp salad, I have just under 100 grams of hand-peeled shrimp that I'm going to chop really fine. And you could process this in a food processor. You don't want it to be a paste though. You do want to have some texture to it. And if you do find any shell bits or legs or antennae, do take them out. Okay, that should be good. Toss that all into a bowl. I'm going to add some herbs. I'm going to do a little dill. We'll do like dill and shrimp. And since I have a bumper crop of basil, we'll use a little basil. And you don't want a whole lot. You don't want this to be overpowering. You're basically about a teaspoon total. And chop it fine. And we're just going to do a little squeeze of fresh lemon. Just a little bit of fresh lemon juice. Make sure you catch any pits that might fall out. We're only doing about a half a teaspoon. There's some shrimp there. Spoon. Okay. I'll just give it a taste. If you want to add some salt, you can, but that is optional and probably not necessary. So I'm just going to add about 2 tablespoons of mayonnaise. And I know normally I recommend making your own mayonnaise. I will put a link up here to my homemade mayonnaise. But for this, it is such a small amount. But you probably don't want to make your own. You're just going to end up with a whole lot of mayonnaise. And unless you use a lot of mayonnaise and other things, it isn't going to stay in the fridge forever. Okay. Let's give it a taste. Yes, that is lovely. Okay, we'll put that aside, clean our board, and then get our sandwiches put together. Okay, so I've decided we're going to use butter for the shrimp and cream cheese for the ham and cheese. Well, obviously, we got to put the cream cheese in the ham and cheese. So, I'm leaving the crust on until I get the butter and the cream cheese spread. That will help the bread keep its form. So I'm doing 1 brown and 1 white for each type of sandwich. So let me just spread the butter on. These two on the end will be the shrimp. So if you took the crust off before you spread your butter or cream cheese, bread would deform. And then you're not going to have a nice square. So for the pound cheese, I'm going to do cream cheese. And I recommend leaving your cream cheese out of the fridge for a little while so it's soft and easy to spread, because this is soft bread. And if your cream cheese is too hard, you're going to have fun trying to spread it. And I'm just using Philadelphia soft cream cheese, and I'm using the light Philadelphia light soft cream cheese. Okay, once we've got everything spread, we need to cut the crusts off. So just the bread knife. Trying not to deform it too much. Okay, so apparently I'm doing the ham and cheese first. Just hang on to the crust in the middle. Okay. So, whatever kind of ham you prefer. I just have some deli baked ham. And we're not making thick sandwiches. We're not stuffing these. They are going to roll up. So I'm going to need a sharp knife to trim the edges on this ham, because we really don't want it hanging over. You can, if you have a good eye and a good judge of space, trim your ham into rectangles before you put it on the bread. I just find, for me, it's easier to put it on and then trim, because then I know where the bread is. Now, give it a little bit of a squash. This out of the way so you can see, just so the bread flattens a little, and then we're going to roll. Okay. Now these are going to be small finger sandwiches, but we're not cutting them yet. These are going to get wrapped in plastic wrap and put in the fridge overnight. And you want to wrap them fairly tightly, kind of like you're doing a sushi roll. And then just twist the ends and fold them under. So we put those in the fridge overnight, and then we slice them in the morning before we put them in our picnic basket. Okay, same procedure for our shrimp, which is going to be a little messier because it's shrimp salad, not sliced meat. So, and oops, I forgot to cut the crust off. My bad. That's okay. There we go. Okay. One spoon. Now we flatten the shrimp and leave a good space at the end there, because the shrimp is going to squish toward that end, so you want room for it to squish out. Without overflowing. And this one is a little harder to flatten, so if you have a fish spatula, that works. And again, roll, gently, and tuck in the stuff that's trying to spill out. And wrap in plastic wrap. Don't worry if a little bit spills out the ends. You clean that up before you cut it. Or just leave it spilled. There we go. And that's our shrimp salad, which will be beautiful pinwheels when we cut them. Very small pinwheels, but they'll be beautiful. So now it's time to load up our picnic basket. Now, my basket is set up for two people. It has knife, fork, spoon for two people, two small plates, and two small glasses. So since there's going to be more of this, and don't want to reuse a dirty dish for our dessert after we've had our lunch, I have in a lovely little bag extra glasses, plates, and bowls, and silverware. And of course, you don't want to forget the napkins. Get yourself some good paper napkins. Toss those in. Now, if it was a really, really hot day, I would be adding an ice pack. But it's coolish today. There even looks like a possibility of rain, although I hope not. So I've got enough cold food. It should be okay. It's not going to be in here by itself that way. Okay, so then we add our food. So heavy stuff in the bottom, obviously. Or the larger it is, the better it would fit in the bottom. So in the middle, dried chicken, potato salad. There's our lovely little sandwiches, and they can go sideways. I have a bin of strawberries, some tea eggs. I will put links to the recipes for the tea eggs and the fried chicken. And I have some little tomatoes out of my garden. And some fresh fruit. And I will pick up drinks on the way. And we need to put my salt and pepper in because I take them out to put them in my lunch box for work. So those just slip in here. There we go. And my picnic basket actually even has a corkscrew, which I have never used because no drinking and driving. And I'm usually the one driving. So I think we have everything ready. Close it all up. And get in the car and head out to our picnic. I'll see you soon. And there's our picnic lunch. We have the potato salad, fruits, fried chicken, little pinwheel sandwiches, and tea eggs. And like I said, I will put links to the recipes for the tea eggs and chicken in the description below.
Yeah, I have a piece.
Please, give me a couple of these. And those.
Yeah, I want a shrimp piece.
Okay, then.
Oh my god, this is good.
So I hope you all enjoyed the video. And if you tried any of the recipes, please leave me a comment telling me what you thought. Please give it a like. Subscribe if you haven't already and hit the bell icon. And I'll be back with you soon with another recipe. Thank you so much for watching.